There's another potential for umpire interference on a two or three man umpiring crew when one of the umpires is drawn in behind the pitcher's mound and he's hit by a batted ball, right?
Right. And it's happened to all of us. It's embarrassing. You don't like when it happens to you. But when it happens, you've got to enforce the rules. So what we're going to do is we're going to give the batter first base. All runners are going to move up if they're forced, unless the ball has touched or passed a fielder, not including the pitcher. If it touches or passes a fielder, then the ball's alive and in play.
Stat and Mike Socia. I mean, this is a break for the Cubs, big break for the Cubs, because the inning pretty much ends.
All right, we got a runner at first and second, or the base is loaded. That's why our umpire is on the third base side. And we're going to have a ground ball. He's going to try to get out of the way. If it takes a bad hop and hits him, we'll see what he does to enforce it. All right, so the batter runner is going to get first base, and all the runners that are forced, they're going to get a base also.
So if an umpire is hit